on to modern physics, it's just only introduction and maybe for some time. Okay, look here first. Have you all know about light? Light. All of you know light. What is light? What is light? EC3. What is light, man? What is light?
So it's the thing which makes things visible.
It is a thing which makes visible. Okay, good.
Because of light, we are able to see things.
Yes, okay.
Reflection of light.
Right, okay, fine. Then EC57. EC57.
Yes, sir.
What is electromagnetic spectrum, ma? What is electromagnetic spectrum? What is electromagnetic spectrum?
Sir, spectrum which is influenced by electricity and magnet.
Electric field and
magnetic field.
Okay. Is light an electromagnetic wave? EC63, is light an electromagnetic wave, man?
Yeah.
Okay.
The wave caused by electromagnetics.
Okay. So is it an electromagnetic wave? Yes. Okay. Then Ami Verma, EC12. What are gamma rays, man? EC12, Ami Verma. What are gamma rays? Is it exposure to gamma rays? Is it safe for us or it is harmful for us?
Sir, can you repeat the question?
Yeah, question is Ami Verma is boy or girl?
Sir, girl.
Okay, fine. See, question is, what is gamma rays? Is exposure to, suppose we get exposed to gamma rays, is it safe for us? Is it recommended for us to get exposed to gamma rays or it is harmful for us?
So it is radioactive. So
yes, correct. So it is exposure to those rays are very harmful for us, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Fine, I think people are trying to get what I am trying to tell. Okay, look here. So this is what people had been knowing. Many scientists try to describe what is light, what light is. Okay, it began with Newton, Foucault. Then there was Maxwell who told that it is an electromagnetic wave. Then there was Einstein. Einstein's explanation, all these things came much later. So prior to that, how was light perceived? Light was a part of an electromagnetic spectrum. So what is the visible range of electromagnetic wave? Sorry, what is what is the visible range of electromagnetic spectrum? So it was those wavelengths that had that were between 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. All the radiations whose wavelength was between 4000 to 7000 angstrom, those were called as light. Light visible range, Vip Gayar. Okay, now look here. So the first thing that people tried to understand was what was light. Okay, therefore quantum mechanics actually began from there only. Okay, it happened in the beginning of 20th century. Okay, roughly by say 1875 means it was 1875 or 1880. Okay, that's where in India we were struggling for independence. So that was the time where people had some understanding about, or almost much understanding about light. Okay, next question is light, is it a wave or is it a particle? Light, is it a wave or is it a particle?
Both.
Who said it is both? It is both, correct? Yeah, it behaves both as a wave as well as a particle, correct? But the time period I was referring to you, that is around say 1875 or 1875 to 1900. During that time, it was considered that light was only behaving as waves but not as particles. You got my point? Photoelectric effect and all came only in 1920. Therefore, that is where some new experiments were discovered, and that we called it as what? Modern physics. Okay, so therefore now what we will do, we will look through two important things. One is the history of description of light. Next one is Newton's second law of motion. All these things were quite well established by 1850 to 1915, 1915, but after that some new experiments came. Therefore, all the existing theory was unable to explain the findings of new experiments. Okay, therefore that is what we are now going to go through in the next few lines. Okay, light behaves as a wave as well as a particle, that is correct, but let us see how was light described. Okay, now look here, the description of light, it many scientists were there who tried to explain light. Okay, therefore whatever I'm showing in the next one paragraph, this is some 400 years, these were the efforts that were put by various scientists for around 400 years. Okay, that is whatever I'm telling in the next one paragraph. It is just a summary of what happened over the 400 years in order to understand or to describe what light is. Okay, so therefore it will be between say 1600 to 1850 or 1500 to 1850 AD, during that time, those time gap of 300 to 400 years, various people tried to understand light. Okay, therefore let us walk through that paragraph. Okay, I think I'll just take this. Okay, introduction, first starts with modern physics. From there only quantum mechanics emerged. Therefore modern physics has just to deal with these two paragraphs. Okay, therefore let us move on. Okay, pa. So history of the description of light. So let me first focus on that. Okay, I think it's visible. Yes. So I can. Yes, pa. Okay, I think this is visible. Good enough. I think someone wants to join. Okay, pa. So look here. How did various people try to understand the nature of light? Look here. So this happened between, say, 300 years of effort is being put in one small paragraph. Okay. What is light? Light is a form of energy. Okay. What is light? Light is a form of energy. Okay. By light, we mean light refers to the visible range of an electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, visible range of an electromagnetic spectrum means the wavelength of light will lie between 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. Okay, for example, violet may have wavelength which is very close to 4000, and red color may have a wavelength which is close to 700 nanometers. So Vip Gayar is, or all those seven colors has wavelength between 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. This is what we know. Okay, next, various scientists made several attempts to describe what light is. Okay, it includes, for example, the Newton's corpuscular theory of light, then the Huygens wave theory of light. Okay, now let me begin with Newton's corpuscular theory. Okay, what is Newton's corpuscular theory means? See, if a bulb is glowing, see, if a bulb glows, you can see rays of light coming from it. Correct? No. So according to Newton, a source which is emitting light, he said that it is made up of particles which is called as corpusculars. Okay, once again I'll repeat, I try to understand. The particle nature of light was actually told by Newton somewhere around 1700 to 1800 Okay, so roughly 250 years ago only he told that light can behave as particles, and those particles he called it as corpuscular or corpuscles. Okay, so therefore when these party, according to Newton, a source emitting light will is made up of these corpuscular. Okay, for example, if I have to draw it by a diagram, if this is a bulb, okay, light will move in the form of particles. Okay, this we call it, this he called it as what? Corpuscles. Okay, and it is spread in space. Okay, and you have humpty number. So when these particles, if they come and fall in our eye, that will create a sensation of sight in us. That is what he told. Okay, what did Newton tell? Newton told that a source that is emitting light, it is made up of particles, which is called as corpuscular or corpuscles, which when it falls on our naked eye, it creates the sensation of sight. Okay, now look here, there were several properties of light. Okay, light exhibited several properties, such as light moves in a straight line, then you have reflection, then you have refraction, correct? These were some basic properties that were observed from light. So using Newton's corpuscular theory, look here, using Newton's corpuscular theory, so these basic properties of light was explained, which were those, the fact that it propagates in a straight line, then reflection, the fact that it propagates in a straight line and reflection. So this was successfully explained by Newton. Okay, also Newton tried to explain the refraction that was occurring, but this had some glitch. Okay, he tried to explain refraction. What is refraction? Refraction is the phenomenon of bending of light when it moves from one medium to another medium. Okay, for example, if light travels from air to water, so light will bend according to the particle theory. You can tell, okay, it propagates in a straight line, so using that you can explain refraction. Okay, one second, I'll repeat. Look here, Newton was able to explain the fact that light moves in a straight line, then he was able to explain reflection, but he was unable to explain refraction based on the Newton's corpuscular theory of light. He was unable to explain why it was, I will tell later. Okay, this is clear. Now, according to Newton, what happened was, according to Newton's corpuscular theory, what it predicts is, see, if light moves from air to water, if light moves from air to water medium, okay, if light moves from air to water medium. For example, if you are looking someone inside water who is swimming, and you are a spectator who is outside, in that case, what happens? Rays of light will move from air to water medium. Okay, clear? No, right? So according to Newton's corpuscular theory, what happened? It predicted that light will travel with more speed in water. According to Newton, the speed of light, I'll just write it as speed of light, I will just simply write it as V. Okay, speed of light in water is greater than speed of light in air. That is what Newton actually predicted. Okay, but what actually happened is the other way around. Okay, one second, I'll repeat. According to Newton's corpuscular theory of light, he predicted that light moves faster in water than in air, which is actually wrong. Okay, now let us look at Huygens' wave theory of light. Okay, therefore Newton's corpuscular theory of light was able to explain the rectilinear propagation means it moves in a straight line. Then reflection was explained, but not refraction. Refraction was not, could not be explained by Newton because of this problem. Okay, next it was Huygens. Huygens was a scientist who tried to visualize visualize, who tried to visualize light as though it is moving as wave. Okay, what is wave? Wave is a disturbance that gets propagated, which gets transferred to the immediate neighborhood, and hence it will spread in space. Okay, or it will expand in space. Okay, what is wave? Wave is disturbance that leads to propagation of energy from one point to another point. Okay, what does that mean? Is it means that the disturbance that is created at one point will get transferred to the immediate neighborhood because of the elastic property of the material. We'll not get into all those details. Just understand this much. What is wave? Wave is a disturbance that will move away from a source and it will expand. That's all. Okay. So using Huygens wave theory of light, he was also able to explain many things, such as light will, I will use a blue color. I will use, for example, blue color. Yeah. Red color is Newton, blue color is Huygens. Okay, he was able to explain rectilinear propagation of light. He was able to explain reflection, and he also tried to explain refraction of light. Okay, according to Huygens wave theory, what happened? According to Huygens wave theory, the speed of light in air is going to be more when compared to speed of light in water. Okay, so this is what actually is true. Experimentally, this is what is true. Okay, what is that? Light will move faster in air and slower in water. But Newton's was the other way around. Okay, Newton's was this prediction, which is wrong. Okay, later there was a scientist by name Fackelt who measured the speed of light experimentally. Okay, so using Huygens wave theory of light, using Huygens wave theory of light, so people were able to explain. I'll use a blue color. So people were able to explain many properties, such as light travels in a straight line, I already told. Okay, reflection, refraction, polarization, interference, diffraction, all these various Huygens wave theory of light, all these things they were able to explain. Okay, Newton's was able to explain only the first initial two properties, but not refraction. Okay, next, what happened? There was a scientist by name Fackelt. So he lakh kilometer per second. Okay, light travels at a speed of around 3 lakh kilometer per second, or 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. So once Fackelt was able to measure the speed of sound, then Huygens and Fackelt, they experimentally tried to verify the speed of light in different medium, and they found that the light travels faster in air and slower in water. Therefore, with the help of Fackelt, the wave theory, the Huygens wave theory of light, it gained an upper hand, or it got an experimental support. Okay, I think I'll use black line. So this got an experimental support, and Newton's corpuscular theory of light, or Newton's particle nature of light, was ignored. Okay, or that was discarded. Okay. Likewise, Maxwell, he was a scientist who proved that X-rays are electromagnetic in nature. Likewise, Maxwell was successfully able to prove that light is part of an electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, once again, I'll repeat. Okay, kindly understand, what do you mean by light? We are referring to all those seven visible colors, or seven colors that fall in the visible range. Violet, indigo, blue, orange, red, and so on. Correct? No. So light means what? It refers to those wavelengths that are visible to naked eye. Okay. So therefore, by Maxwell, with the help of Maxwell, people came to know that light also will behave as waves. And in fact, it will have electric field and magnetic field associated with it. Therefore, we call that, we that put together, we call it as what? Electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, is this clear? So thus, hence, by the beginning of 20th century, by the beginning of 20th century means what? For example, 1902. Okay, by beginning of 20th century, light was known to behave as particles. Light was known to behave as waves. Okay, so all people are with me. Okay, by the beginning of 20th century, that is, for example, 1903 AD. So all the scientists around the world, they had an understanding that light will behave as waves. Light cannot be a particle as was initially formulated by Newton. And next, light is part of an electromagnetic spectrum. So if a light moves, what will happen? It will produce electric field and magnetic field associated with it. That's all. So therefore, at that point of time, in the beginning of 20th century, all had the understanding that light will behave as waves. Okay. So this is one phase of a coin. Okay. Light will behave as waves is what the at all no. Okay, clear? No. So whatever I showed in one paragraph, it's actually an effort that several scientists over 3 to 4 centuries to decide or to understand the properties of light. Okay, you had Kirchhoff, you had Newton. Newton discovered the spectrometer. So Kirchhoff started to analyze the spectrometer by various elements. Okay, and so on. Okay, so therefore Maxwell, all these people try to give a better understanding of what light is. Okay, clear? Next, what happened? This is one thing. Next, we have Newton's second law of motion. What is Newton's second law of motion? So, according to Newton's second law of motion, what is Newton's second law? Newton's second law is force acting on a particle will be equal to mass into acceleration. Okay? I will move on to this part. Close this. Okay, can you see? This is Newton's second law of motion. So Newton's second law, we all know what is that force acting to acceleration and so on. Okay, now look here, using Newton's second law of motion, position and location. Position means position, the position and motion of waves could see by naked eyes, including motion of planets, could be completely described with the help of Newton's second law of motion. Okay, in fact, the GPRS that we use today, it is actually based on Newton's second law of motion. Okay, also some relativistic correction will come into picture that is in day-to-day life is, it could be ignored. Okay, but over a period of 1,000 years, it becomes very important. So, but when you want to travel from one point to another for 10 hours of journey, that will not matter. Okay, therefore, using Newton's, our GPRS also works based on Newton's second law of motion. Okay, next came what? So therefore, by the beginning of 20th century, all thought that everything is known about light and the whole of this world is under their fingertips. Okay, so they thought that Newton's second law of motion and everything is known about light. That is what they thought. But later what happened? Let's see. Okay. So here what happened? Okay. See, all of you are with me? People are with me?
Yes, sir.
EC57.
Yes, sir.
You are with me? Okay. Look here. See, the world was very good. You could travel from any point, one point to another point, or if you want to go to your say closer, say your parents' house, you could board a flight and go. All these things were fine unless Corona hit. Correct? No? Am I right? The world is open. Okay? World is open. Changes in the biology, biological structure, in microorganisms, in human beings, in dinosaurs, all these things will happen. It is part of the dynamical process of this world. Okay? You cannot avoid. We cannot stop. It will happen. Mutations, all these things will occur. Okay? Likewise, look here. So people had all that freedom, but in 2019 December, what happened? COVID-19 emerged. A new disease emerged and people did not have a medicine to treat it. Correct? No? Am I right? So new things will occur. Many things will occur. It is bound to happen. So therefore you cannot tell everything has come to a standstill. You cannot guarantee it. Okay? Things will dynamically change. Likewise. Okay? And we all know the later part of the story. We had COVID-19, first wave, second wave, and vaccination drive is, they're trying to minimize the risk. So all these things were the efforts that were put in the last 1.5 years. Correct? Right? Likewise, just understand the context. Okay? So, likewise, look here. So until that point, that is in the beginning of 20th century, say 1905, people thought that they know everything about light and Newton's second law of motion is able to reveal many things. Okay? So look here, at those point of time, based on those two, that is the fact that light behaves as a wave and you have Newton's second law of motion, it led to what? Let us see in this next one paragraph. Okay? Yeah. I think I'll just rule it out this. Okay, now see here, pa. Okay, so the fact that light behaves as a wave and it is part of an electromagnetic spectrum, then you have Newton's second law of motion, which can help us to locate the position and also the future course of particle with these things. So people or scientists around the world came to the conclusion that these led to the conclusion that matter means we call it as particles. Okay. And energy means it is waves. Okay. In fact, Einstein's mass energy relation, that is, you can using mass, you can derive energy out of it, and using energy, you can convert it into mass. So Einstein's theory of relativity, all those things came only in 1930s, 1940s, okay, much later. So in the beginning of 20th century, what was perceived, the people perceived that matter and energy were considered to be two different things and they are not related to each other. Okay, but few new experiments were discovered. Okay, so for example, black body radiation was discovered in, say, 1908. Photoelectric effect was discovered in 1915. Then Compton effect was discovered in 1919, in that range. Okay, so just like how we know that we have the medicines, just like how we perceive that. Just like how we think that we have the cure for all existing disease, that is what we perceived, and we found that many new diseases can come for which we have to devise new medicines. Correct? Likewise, certain new experiments or new findings were found, which are those included. Okay? Few new findings were discovered. Which were those? So few new experiments such as black body radiation, photoelectric effect, then Compton effect, etc. These were discovered and these could not be explained by the theories that were already available at that point of the time. So what was the theories that were available at that point of the time? One is Newton's second law of motion. The other one is light will behave as waves, or it is an part of an electromagnetic spectrum. All these things could not explain black body radiation, then photoelectric effect and Compton effect. Okay, and later you will see that Einstein was able to explain photoelectric effect by considering it as a particle. Okay, therefore, so through Einstein, again, particle nature of light gained momentum. Okay, so these new experiments could not be explained by the theories that were available at that point of time. So therefore, what you have to do? A new disease has come. So therefore, what we have to do? So we have to learn, or we have to devising new methods to find a cure for it. Okay, likewise, what we have to do? So we have to be COVID warriors. Okay, we have to fight and stop corona. That is what our objective should be. Okay, likewise, what is the aim? So you have to come up with some new theories. Okay, so that is new ideas. So the new theory that were formulated by modifying the old theory in order to explain these new observations or findings, that led to the development of a new theory called quantum mechanics. Okay, I think I should not use new theory 4-5 times. I think it's only once it's enough. Okay, so the new theory that were formulated by modifying the old ideas in the light of new observations, that led to a new theory which we call it as quantum mechanics. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so what gave rise to Sputnik that was developed by India, or Covin or Covishield from India? It is the emergence of new disease and a way to tackle or find a cure for it. Likewise, these new findings such as photoelectric effect, black body radiation, Compton effect, etc. So these were explained by modifying the old theories, and that gave rise to a new theory which we call it as quantum mechanics. Okay, so using quantum mechanics, people were able to explain many things, including electricity, then the electrical properties of materials. All these things could be explained using quantum mechanics. Okay, therefore I think I will just stop here. Details about quantum mechanics we will come to know, we will deal it in the next class. Okay, how black body radiation, see, this is not there, the first initial 2 pages is not there in the syllabus, but these are necessary background for us to understand what is quantum mechanics. Okay, so therefore I'll stop here. In the next class we'll quickly walk through the black body spectrum and see what is quantization of energy. Okay, so I think we made a good beginning at this point, so I will stop here. No need to confuse you further, because your mind is more occupied with the existing first internal test. Therefore I will stop here. Okay, so shall I take your attendance?